guys, today I want to give you a comparison between three different forms of an equation of a straight line. Also, I will come up with an example of an equation of a straight line and how to turn it into one of these forms. Generally speaking, the equation of a straight line can be given in three different forms, namely slope-intercept form, which is basically, I think, most used. Also point slope form and so-called general form, or sometimes it says a standard form. Now, all of these forms, they're interchangeable. So let's take a quick look at the first one. So slope intercept form basically means when your variable y is isolated, so y is explicitly written in terms of x, and the coefficient in front of x, this pink m, basically represents the slope or gradient, if you will, of this straight line. So basically the gradient, put it in a nutshell, shows you the steepness. The steepness, how steep is your line. So rise over arm, in other words. Or if it comes to calculating a slope, it's just the difference in y's over the difference in x's. And B means the y-intercept. So it's the distance when your graph intersects y-axis. So the distance from the zero, from the origin to your graph. Now, point slope form is kind of similar to slope intercept form. The difference is x1 and y1, it's the coordinate of a point lying on a straight line. So if it comes to, let's say, geometrical interpretation, that means it's just if you have a straight line. So this point, let's say A, which has coordinates, all right, I will draw a full picture. X1 and Y1, yeah, right? So this point belongs this straight line. So this M still indicates the slope, the gradient. And basically, yes, that's all. And finally, the general form is just the equation containing x and y, and normally with coefficients in front, and you have this constant c sticking around. Some people write it on the right side. Please do not correct me, okay? Sometimes it's written this way, so c can be moved to or bring to the right side. So it's precisely the same idea. Say you have been given the equation of a straight line, something like y minus 2 equals 3x minus 1. Let's put it in the easiest way possible. Now, as you might see, this equation of a straight line is given in the point slope form. So you could just match up. You're given your y1 basically is this. Let me grab another one. Y1 is basically this 2. You are given the slope, which is 3. So so this 3 is your slope m. So this is your slope. X stays the same, it's the variable in your equation, and your x1 is just this 1. Now, you could rearrange this equation and turn it into either slope-intercept form or a standard form. So, I would like to show you both ways. So the way you rearrange this formula and turn it into other forms is just applying algebra. So all you need to do is just algebraically manipulate with this formula. So all you do, first of all, you want to distribute these three over these two terms. Open up and remove the parentheses. So keep in mind that three distributes and applies to both terms inside. So in the next line, keep y minus 2 at this point. 3 times x gives you 3x minus 3. 3 times negative 1 minus 3. Now, let's come up with slope-intercept form first. For the slope-intercept form, you want to get your y alone on the left side. So whatever attach your y, so in this case it's negative 2, move it, bring it to the right side by doing opposite. So you want to basically add 2 to both sides of your equation. So you add 2, you add 2. And you end up getting, so bring down this y at this point, 2 goes away, bye-bye, disappeared, bring down 3x, and 2 minus 3, and you would be left with negative 1. So that's your slope-intercept form for this equation. Notice that your slope is 3. This is your slope. So it's still the same. Look, you can compare the first one and the first equation that you were given originally and what we got. So slope still remains the same. Even if you look at these two, the general equations, right? So this slope, because it's just the coefficient in front of your x, so it still remains the same. It's the same numbers, the same number. Whereas the constant, basically, they changed, since now this negative 1 represents y-intercept. So it's y-intercept. Whereas this 1 and this 2, they are basically the coordinates of a point that belongs to a line. Now, so again, so this is your slope, and this is your negative 1, this is your y-intercept. Now, let's turn the same equation, this point slope form, let's convert it into standard or general form, if you will. So again, at this point, look at the standard form. So it does not have the brackets, any brackets in it. So remove the brackets first of all, basically like we did before. So I'm going to just rewrite this line over here. So y minus 2 equals 3x minus 3. Now, for standard general form, all you do is just combine all your terms on the left side. Basically, you could move this 3x to the left side, but 3x becomes negative. So I want to avoid, I don't want to deal with negative. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to bring these two terms to the right side. So it becomes 3x. I'm going to subtract this y from both sides, and basically I'm writing in the opposite and the reverse order. So I'm going to subtract this y from both sides of your equation, and also I'm going to move this 2 to the right side. So I'm going to remove 2 from the left side and bring it to the right side by adding 2 to both sides of your equation. So it comes out to be, so 3x minus y, and we have minus 3 plus 2, and you end up getting, so it's the same thing as 2 minus 3, so negative 1, and that equals 0. That's your general form, that's your standard form, if you will, for that equation. Notice that they're kind of similar, and basically, look at this. You could get this equation from that point. Look, since we're given over here, we've got y equals 3x minus 1, all you do is just bring this y to the right side, And you are left with the x minus y minus 1. That's precisely the same thing over there. But I did it from the beginning, from scratch, because, as I said before, I wanted to show you the way how to convert this form into a general form. So now, let's say, if you are given something like this, slope-intercept form, you could easily convert it from this form into a general or a standard form. With this being said, I hope it has been helpful to you. Huge thanks for watching and train your brain. I know everyone hates maths, but if you like my video, please hit this like, share with your friends, leave the comments down below, and be sure to smash that subscribe button so you'll not miss out my new videos. Point slope form, vice versa. Quadratic equation. Quadratic equation, no. It's not quadratic. Your brain has stopped. Not equivalent.